friends, I welcome you all for GD&T Learning Together. I am thankful to all subscribers and viewers for amazing response. Today we are going to discuss one more interesting topic, that is, what is 3-2-1 principle. The structure of our discussion would be, what is degrees of freedom? Even though degrees of freedom is rudimentary, it is essential to reflect on it for our easy understanding. What is 3-2-1 principle? The criteria for datum selection, points to remember, and if you have any questions, I'll be glad to answer them. Please feel free to post them. Let us consider an object in space. Any object in space can move up, can move down, can move left, can move right, and it also can rotate. That means it can have a translational motion along x-axis, along y-axis and z-axis, and it also can have a rotational motion along x-axis, is termed as u, and along y-axis it is termed as v, along z-axis it is termed as w. Any object in space will have 6 degrees of freedom, 3 transitional and 3 rotational, as shown above. What is 3-2-1 principle? Let us consider an example in order to understand this concept clearly. Consider this cover plate with 2 holes. Let bottom surface be datum A and surface along the length be datum B, surface along width be datum C. And these 2 holes are located using position tolerance with respect to A, B, C. 3-2-1 rule define the minimum points of contact with primary datum as 3, secondary datum as 2 and tertiary datum as 1. Let us see how this pans out in practical. That means when the datums are simulated, how this is going to pan out. Let us consider this datum reference frame. The red color simulator is datum A, the blue color simulator is datum B, and the black color simulator is datum C. Let us see when cover plate is placed on these datum simulators. We know that bottom surface is datum A and surface along the length is datum B and surface along the width is datum C. Let us see how these datums are going to restrict degrees of freedom. The primary datum A will restrict rotation around x-axis, it will restrict rotation around y-axis, and it will rotate moment along z-axis. Primary datum A restricts 3 degrees of freedom. Let us see the secondary datum B. Secondary datum B restricts the rotation around z-axis, moment along y-axis, and secondary datum restricts 2 degrees of freedom. Similarly, the tertiary datum C is going to restrict moment along x-axis. Tertiary datum restricts 1 degrees of freedom. The primary datum restricts 3 degrees of freedom, secondary datum restricts 2 degrees of freedom, tertiary datum restrict 1 degrees of freedom. So criteria for datum selection. Datum features are selected to meet design requirement. They should be functional surfaces, it should be either mating surface where it will go and butt with one more part, or slide on the surface, and readily accessible. The datum selected should be readily accessible when it is used for manufacturing, inspection or assembly. And datum should have a sufficient length so that it can be repeatedly produced for manufacturing, assembly, inspection. Sufficient length to simulate and measure. This is the datum reference frame of 3-to-1 principle. Points to remember. 3-to-1 rule only applicable for planar parts. Datum selection is purely driven by functional relation between parts. It's not always mandatory to arrest all 6 degrees of freedom. It depends on the geometry and functional requirement of the part. Coming soon, I'll be planning on what are the form controls. I request all the viewers to subscribe the channel so that we don't miss any of our discussions. Thank you.